Are you aware that we're in Delaware? Yes. That's nice. Oh, you went from yep to mm-hmm. Very good. MashaAllah. This is my dear friend. Tell everybody your name again.
Muhammad.
Muhammad. And where's... there she is. Tell everybody your name.
Fatima.
Fatima. MashaAllah. And we got some other folks here too. And... Brothers and sisters, right. You're right. Boys and girls, right? Yeah.
All of us are brothers and
sisters. Wait a minute. We're all brothers and sisters? Yeah. Even me?
Yeah.
I'm one old brother, huh? Yeah. Yo, yeah.
In real life,
yeah. Yeah, I think we're pretty much in real life. I hope so. I want to stay like that, too. Do you want to stay in real life? Yeah, me too. It kind of works out good, right? And one of the things that we want to talk about is the importance of life itself. Did you know, Muhammad, that in the Quran, Allah tells us about life? He tells us that He's the one who gives life. Allah is the one who gives people life. He also tells us the importance of preserving life. Did you know that if you save somebody's life, it's like you saved all the people in the world? Did you know Allah said that in the Quran? Did anybody tell you that? No, they should tell you. If you save one person's life, Allah, He will give you like you saved the whole world. But if anybody kills somebody, even one innocent life, it's like he killed everybody in the whole world. This is what Islam teaches. So when people are talking about killing somebody, did you know that even one is like they killed everybody? So it's very serious. It's not a joke. And one of the things that we're talking about tonight is how important it is for us to have a voice, right? Mm-hmm. Do we need a voice?
Yes.
Yes, because people won't know what Islam is if we don't tell them. Do you think that Hindus should tell people about Islam? No. It doesn't make sense. Should the Jewish people have to tell everybody about Christianity? No. Do the Christians have to tell everybody about being Hindus? No, that's not their job. What's our job? To tell everybody about what?
Islam.
And if we don't do that, what will happen? They'll have the wrong idea. And they'll, even some Muslims, they don't know. They don't know what's Islam. They'll say, I'm a Muslim. And you ask them a few questions, like, do you know the Quran? Yes, yes, I know the Quran. Okay. What does it say about life? I don't know. And that's one of the most important things. Did you know that? Yeah. Very important. Okay, but I'm going to ask you a question. Is there a God?
Yes.
What's his name? Allah. Did you know that there's a word in Arabic that means God? What is it?
Ar-Rahman.
Nope. That's one of his names. I didn't ask you what his name is. I ask you, there's a word in Arabic that means God.
Rab?
No, that means Lord.
Allah?
That's his name. That's his name. What's the word in Arabic for God? Who knows? Ilah. Ilah. Ilah means God. Allah is the name of the one and only Ilah. Something could be an Ilah, right? Some people worship the ground. Some people worship the sun. Some people worship the moon. Some worship stars. Some worship rocks and stones and idols and fire.
What?
Did you know people worship fire? Fire worshipers. They're called Majusi. Why do they do it? I guess you'd have to ask them. I never did worship fire. I made a lot of mistakes, but I don't think I made that one. But I want to ask you something. If we know that there is one God, only one God, and we even know his name is Allah, shouldn't we tell people about that?
Yes.
So this is going to be our effort to tell people the most important thing. And I want to tell you a little short story. You ready? Okay. Do you know that there was somebody who lived at the time of Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him? We say, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, exactly. There was somebody then at that time, his name was Mu'adh. Have you ever heard this name, Mu'adh?
He's my brother.
Your brother?
No, he's not.
He must be pretty old. That's 1,400 years ago.
Yeah, he's 14.
Yeah. So, Mu'adh bin Jabal, that's his name. Mu'adh bin Jabal. And so, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he said, Ya Mu'adh, which means, Oh Mu'adh, I'm calling you, right? And he said, Labaik wa Sadaik, which means, I'm listening. I'm here. I'm at your service. Go ahead, tell me. He said, I'm going to send you to a place in the south called Yemen. Yemen. And when you get there, I want you to tell the people, La ilaha illallah. Tell the people, there's no God. There is no God except only one God named Allah. That's the only real God. And if they believe you, if they accept it, then tell them how to do the connection, the salah. And if they accept that, then tell them about the charity, the zakah. And if they do that, then tell them about Ramadan. And then Hajj. That was Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, telling who? Mu'adh bin Jabal. What to say when he got there? What was the first thing he said? Tell him about what?
La ilaha
illallah. He didn't say tell him about hijab. He didn't say tell him to grow a beard. He didn't say tell him don't drink. Said what? Tell him about la ilaha illallah. Because if they don't know that, if they don't know there's a God and they don't know even know his name, then you need to stay on that subject. And the problem is we haven't been doing that. So now people have the wrong idea. You know, some people think we worship a moon god. Did you hear about that?
A moon god?
One man wrote a whole book called The Moon God, called Allah. And they gave him a lot of money. And then he started lecturing in the universities. And they paid him a lot of money to lecture in the university about a moon god. Do we worship a moon god?
No.
He even said that there's a moon inside of the Kaaba.
What? No.
A what? He said there's a moon god inside the Kaaba and all of us are praying to it. They pay him a lot of money to say that. I hope after this TV series that he won't get a job anymore doing that. We don't mind people having their beliefs, but we don't like them to tell other people that we believe something we don't believe. We believe that Allah will punish people if they do bad things, right? Now, I'm going to ask you a question. We love Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right?
Yes.
We love him so much, right?
Yes.
A lot. But we don't pray to him, do we?
No.
No. We pray to the God that he used to pray to, right?
Yes.
Is that right? He used to pray to Allah, so we pray to Allah. Does that make sense?
Yes.
And Jesus, we believe in him too, right?
Yes.
As what? Miracle birth. He did miracles. He's with Allah. He'll be back in the last day. That's Jesus. We believe in that. But we don't believe he's God, do we? And we don't pray to Jesus. But we pray to the God that he prayed to. What about Moses? You remember Moses, alayhi salam? You know Moses? Yeah? Did he pray to God?
Yes.
Did he tell people pray to God?
Yes.
Yeah. So we believe in Moses and we pray to the same God he prayed to. What about Abraham, alayhi salam? Yeah? And what did he figure out? There's only one God.
Mm-hmm.
Pray to him.
Yeah.
And he told all of his children to do the same thing, right?
Yeah.
And that's what we're supposed to tell the children. Do people tell you that in the Tarbiyah school? Just pray to one God, Allah?
Yeah.
That's good. They tell you to respect other people, take care of people, don't hurt people. They teach you that?
Mm-hmm.
And don't kill anybody, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's good. Wait, tell me again.
If you kill one man, you kill the whole mankind.
That's true. That's what the Quran says. You're pretty smart. Yeah, I bet you got brains that you don't even bother to use, huh? MashaAllah. So what we're learning really is the importance of us telling everybody. How can we do it? Now suppose that we get a sign. You know, I see some people on TV, sometimes they have a sign. And it says something on it at a football game or something like that. They hold up a sign. Have you seen that? Or if they're having a demonstration, people hold up a sign, you know, that we want more money for our work we do or something like that, right? So should we get signs and stand on the street corner all day saying, we believe in Allah?
No.
No, that's too much, isn't it?
No.
Besides, only people here in Delaware would know about it. In fact, only people that here in this new Ark area would know, right?
Yes.
Actually, only on our street where the mustard is, right? So we need to get the word out. How are we going to do that? Well, you want to go to everybody's house and knock on the door? Hi, I'm a Muslim. Is that a good idea?
No.
Not a good idea? Why? Besides the fact they might slam the door in your face, what else? You can scare people. Or they might just say, you know what? I don't want to buy whatever you're selling. And you say, I'm not selling anything. They say, no, right? But what about the importance of us having our own TV channel and people will watch it? Do you know why people watch our channel more than any other channel? It's free. Guidance TV is free. You don't have to pay for satellite. You don't have to pay for cable. You don't have to pay for antenna. You don't have to pay for anything. You can do it, but if you have internet, you got to pay your internet bill. But we don't charge anybody. That's only one thing. You know what the second thing is? No advertising. Do you know that we don't have any advertising on Guidance TV? No ads. That means you can watch all day long and never have to deal with the thing. You know what they say? It slices, it dices, it cuts, and it chops. And don't answer right now because we're going to send you two. Just two. That's right. Wait a minute. We'll send you three. That's right. We'll charge it to your credit card, 1-800, and we'll send it. Have you seen those ads?
Yes.
Yeah? Are they boring?
Yes.
Do you wish they didn't have them?
Yes.
Well, we don't have them, not on Guidance TV. So no advertising, no infomercials, no charge. And so when somebody's watching, they go through with a click, 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 click. When somebody else has a commercial, they'll just go click and, hey, there's something. And they see, of course, they see very interesting people, us, right? Are we interesting?
Yes.
Yes, we are. Actually, kind of cute. But anyway. So people watch us. And they say, that's interesting. And they might just learn something. And speaking of learning something, I want to take this little break so that we can learn something. We're going to put something on right now, guys. Watch real close. You're sitting at home. Watch what we got coming up right here. And then when we come back, we're going to have something real special for everybody. So don't go away. Stay right where you are and get guided with
Guide Us TV.
I love the way they say that.